Over in the U.S., the gunman who shot and killed six people at a Walmart in Chesapeake, Virginia, has been identified as the store's overnight manager. An employee who survived the attack told the U.S. media the 31-year-old gunman entered the staff break room and just opened fire. Police say he died due to self-inflicted gunshot wounds. His motive remains unknown. This is the second mass shooting in the state just this month. Last November 13, three University of Virginia students were killed by a classmate after a field trip.
The rest of this investigation is ongoing. It is just a horrendous event. Our hearts are just completely broken this morning, yet again, in the Commonwealth of Virginia. Today, our job is to support families who are facing the unthinkable today. Families who have lost a loved one or have a loved one who is injured. And our job today is to come around them and support them.
Walmart, America's largest retailer, says it's working with law enforcement and focused on supporting its associates that were affected by the tragedy. And let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now with our correspondent, Romel Conclara.
Good morning, Mike and Nikki. Here's the latest stories making the headline amongst the Filipino community.
We begin in Hope Community Church in Surrey, British Columbia, where mourners came in droves to show their support for the Belgica family. Many of them have helped the family in their search for 18-year-old Ethan Belgica, son of community leader Cliff Belgica, when he was reported missing on October 22nd. The search ended when a body that fit Ethan's description washed ashore in West Vancouver last November 4th.
Those who have helped and come, when we called to bring Ethan home, everyone in the community, we are more than amazed at all the help that you have given us and to continue to give us.
Cliff said that looking back, they regret that they did not see the signs that Ethan was struggling from mental health issues and needed help. He added that authorities alluded to 28 jumpers at the Lionsgate Bridge, of which seven were confirmed, but only one of them has surfaced. Ethan. Belgica said his son has come home.
On the job, Philippines.
Let's go to New York, where Filipino director Eric Matsui's masterpiece, On the Job, is now etched in International Emmy Awards history as one of the nominees for Best TV Movie / Miniseries. On the Job is an action-packed thriller based on the shocking true story of prisoners being forced by prison officials to carry out assassinations. The prestigious award, however, went to Help. But for movie producer Don Don Monteverde, the nomination of On the Job alone makes all their hard work worth it.
Happy naman kami sa narating ng project ito, di ba? From Cannes to Venice, ngayon nandito tayo sa Emmys.
Kahit hindi tayo manalo, even being nominated, makikita naman nila, other producers, na parang pwede naman pala magkwento ng iba naman ah. Nang hindi naman yung usual nating kinukwento na melodrama or romantic comedy, pwede naman magkwento ng iba at may pupuntahan din naman pala.
And finally, people got to give back this holiday season in Oakland, California, where Compass Care Collective's third annual turkey giveaway was held. At least 150 turkeys were given away to those in need.
I grew up in this community. I was raised here, so I felt like they gave a lot to me growing up, and this is my way of giving back to them.
Over 35 bags of clothes were also donated by some of the most sought-after streetwear brands in the Bay Area. Philem Alex Martin of Who Cares Supply Company says he was more than happy to help. For Martin, donating clothes wasn't enough. He spent the afternoon handing out turkeys to the community, too.
My family raised me very well, and just to give back, and the people that we work with, we all are caring people, and we just want to do the best that we can just to help the community and give back in any way we can.